Anybody who thinks I can't do it anymore better step right back and take.
Hello again, everyone. This is Abra, and I'm back to give my two cents on Ethan Van Sciver's Cyberfrog Wrecked Planet. It's been a long time coming, but the wait is finally over. I finally got my anxious little hands on EVS's Cyberfrog Wrecked Planet, the highly anticipated follow-up to Cyberfrog Blood Honey. I'm sure the question on mostly everyone's mind is, was it worth the wait? Well, stay tuned to find out. When we last saw the cybernetic amphibian, he had recently awakened from a 20-year-long restorative sleep. Cyberfrog quickly discovers that this is not the same Philadelphia that existed before his explosive plunge into the Schuylkill River. The iconic city of brotherly love is now blanketed with Vespis honeycomb, produced from the blood and bodies of their human victims. Still dazed, he continues his search for Heather that he first started 2 decades earlier. Readers are quickly brought back to the point of the cliffhanger at the conclusion of Blood Honey. There is a touching reunion between Heather and Cyberfrog. What seemed to be only mere minutes for the frog has been a 20-year-long struggle for survival for the woman. Much has changed. Later, Cyberfrog gets a not-so-warm welcome back at the survivors' camp. As Cyberfrog tries to settle in, he observes the life or existence the survivors have carved out for themselves and reassesses his mission. What could have possibly been a boring section of the story was expertly written by EVS. He did a masterful job of highlighting what life was like for the survivors, from daily chores and resource gathering missions to social gatherings like picnics. This all helped illustrate what humanity at its core is really all about. During this time, we meet Lily. She's a sad, tough, no-nonsense girl, and she really misses her father. In this story, we find out he's gone missing, and readers have yet to find out why. She takes some time to warm up to Cyberfrog. She really doesn't know what to make of him. At first, it seems he's kind of a distraction to her mission of trying to find her father. Cyberfrog immediately takes to her and wants to help and protect her. He sees her, along with Heather, as part of his family. Then there's Colin, leader of the survivor group. His perceived image as an authority figure is important to him. For instance, he's supposed to wear glasses, but he never wears them. He's afraid it's gonna make him look weaker. There's a definite arrogance about him. He doesn't like to be challenged, and he's content to maintain the status quo, all so he can remain in charge. Heather has changed a lot over the last 20 years. The last 2 decades have been brutal for her. She, of course, has young Lily to protect, but she lives day to day with constant fear. She was holding out hope for Cyberfrog's return, and she's crushed when she learns that he's offline and disconnected from Chelsin. Reading through the story, I loved hearing more of Cyberfrog's quips and seeing him use his tongue more. It reminded me of his old 90s iteration. There was a cute montage in Wrecked Planet titled Lily and Frog. It highlighted the two hanging out and participating in various activities while bonding. I could almost imagine that this was EVS illustrating events from Lily's diary, if she had one. It also made me think that this could be a way that he could accommodate some fans' requests and have 90s Cyberfrog adventures be stories written by Heather when she was younger. I had no doubt that the art in Wrecked Planet would be exceptional, and of course EVS delivered. There are several really fun action scenes, one in which Cyberfrog plants a severed Vespa's head like a football. There are also nice little details EVS included throughout the book. There's a little Easter egg during the Red Roster scene with Heather, where they go to Walmart and she's accompanied by a guy named Mitch. Wrecked Planet is a huge jump ahead in terms of storytelling over Blood Honey. I feel that EVS needing to quickly introduce all of the characters and the backstory in the first book hampered the tale. The cliffhanger ending where it didn't do it any favors either. While I did enjoy Blood Honey, it left me wanting. Wrecked Planet's ending is far more satisfying by leaps and bounds. I'm still anxious for Red Extermination, the third book, but I feel this cliffhanger was more fitting. I really had to look hard for things to critique in Wrecked Planet. As lame as that might sound, I don't really have anything. I just love the story. If I had to comment on anything, it would be that I wish more had been said regarding Lily's father, Harold. Well, my friends, after finishing the final page and then staring at it for several moments, I could only think of one word. Wow! What an enjoyable and intense journey EVS takes his readers on with this tale. There are so many facets to this story. Loss, heartache, despair, but there is also a message of hope. Well, those are my two cents on Ethan Van Sciver's Cyberfrog Wrecked Planet. Thank you so much for watching. This is Abra. Until next time, take care.
I am Frog King Lord High.